Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial, and today we're looking at shortcut keys in Photoshop. Photoshop ships with a series of shortcut keys that allow you quick access to things like tools and menu options and some of the panel options as well. For example, if I were to press the letter J, watch over here when I do so. When I press the letter J, I target the first of the tools that shares this toolbar position. At the moment, the visible tool is the healing brush tool, so that's what I'm seeing. But there are five tools that all share the same keyboard shortcut. To get access to them, once I press the letter J to target this area of the toolbar, I can then hold down the Shift key and continue to press the letter J, and that will toggle me through all the tools that share that position. Photoshop will group these tools together, so you won't find any J letter tools anywhere else in the toolbar other than here. And there are a set of B tools here for the brush tool. Here in the area that's taken up by the pen tool, two of these tools have the letter P associated with them, but these three tools have no letter associated with them, although I can get to the Add Anchor Point tool by pressing the plus key and the Delete Anchor tool by pressing the minus key, but the Convert Point tool has no key associated with it. Now I would like to associate a key with that tool, so let's see how we'd go and do that. I'm going to choose Edit and then Keyboard Shortcuts. And here in the Keyboard Shortcuts and Menus panel, I can choose shortcuts for panel menus, for application menus, or for tools. And of course, I want to select tools because I want to get to this Convert Point tool. I'll need to scroll down this list to find the Convert Point tool. It's going to be relatively easy to pick up because it won't have a shortcut associated with it. And here it is. Now I can click on the tool name here to target it, and what I need to do is to type a shortcut key that I can use. I've already established that there are two letter shortcut keys that are not in use. They're the letter K and the letter N. Now for me, Convert Point Tool and the letter K, I can mentally associate that letter with that tool. So I'm going to press the letter K. It's not associated with another tool, so I can just go ahead and click Accept. And then I'll click OK. Now let's go and see how this works. I'm going to draw a path with the pen tool. I'll just press Escape to finish. I'm going to target the path selection tool, just select over my path, and I want to convert this anchor point. So I'm going to press the letter K, and you can see that the Convert Anchor Point tool has now been selected, which means that I can click and drag to convert this anchor point. My new tool assignment is working perfectly. In the application menus, as with the tools, you'll see that a number of the menu options already have shortcut keys associated with them, and Photoshop very usefully tells us what those keys are, so we could learn those that are going to be of value to us. But of course, there are plenty of menu options that don't have associated keyboard shortcuts. One I'm interested in is over here on the View menu, the New Guide option. I use that quite a bit. It has no keyboard shortcut associated with it. I'd like to add one. So let's just click away and again choose Edit, Keyboard Shortcuts. This time I'm going to select Application Menus. And I need to go and find the View menu because that's where the New Guide option is. So I'm just going to click here to open up this group of options. And now I'll need to scroll down until I find the New Guide tool. And here it is. I'll click it to target it. And now I need to type a keyboard shortcut to use. Well, I'm thinking Ctrl-Alt-N. So let's just press that. Well, Ctrl-Alt-N is already in use. This icon here is telling me it's already in use, and here we can see what it's being used for. Now, if we click Accept, we're going to disassociate it from the New Document with Last Used Settings option, and we're going to apply it to New Guide. If I don't want to do that, then I need to remove this keyboard shortcut, and I need to find something that I can use. I happen to know that the keyboard shortcut Ctrl-Alt-Q is available, so I'm going to hold down Ctrl and Alt and type the letter Q. And you can see this time that I'm not given any warnings because this is an available keyboard shortcut. I'm going to click Accept and then OK. And now we can test it. I'll hold down Control and Alt, press the letter Q, and here is my new guide dialog. In addition to application menus and tools, you can also assign shortcut keys to panel options. Let's have a look at that. I'll choose Edit and then Keyboard Shortcuts, and this time we're going to choose Panel Menus. And what I'm interested in is a levels adjustment. So I'm just going to go to the Adjustments option and I'm going to scroll down to find levels. Now, in this case, I'm warned that the menu command and the application menu layer new adjustment layer levels must have the same shortcuts. And if I apply a shortcut to the panel option, then it's also going to be applied to the menus. And I'm quite happy with that. Again, I've got a keyboard shortcut I know I can use. It's Alt F3. So I'm going to hold down the Alt key and press the function key F3. We can see that it's available because we're not given any warnings that it's already in use. So I'll click Accept and then click OK. So now if I hold down the Alt key and press the function key F3, you'll see that the new adjustment layer dialog opens and it opens at levels. If we go to the Layers panel here, you'll see that there is a new adjustment layer in this document. If you spend a bit of time customizing your keyboard shortcuts, you want to protect yourself against losing them. So you would do so by choosing Edit and then Keyboard Shortcuts, and you'll want to save those keyboard shortcuts. So just click here on the Save option, and you can go ahead and save them. So you could call them, for example, by your name. I'm just going to call mine Helen's Keys and click Save. And now they're saved on file, so anytime in the future I could come and open that file and reload them. I can also go back to the Photoshop defaults by just selecting them. Now, so far I've been telling you which of the keys are available for use in Photoshop. If you're curious about what the shortcut keys are, and if you want to be able to check and see if a shortcut key is available, then you can click here on the Summarize option. When you click Summarize, you're prompted to save an HTML file. Now, an HTML file is accessible through a web browser, and what it's going to be is a list of my key assignments. So I'm just going to leave it as Helen's Keys, and I'm going to click Save. And when I do this, Photoshop opens a web browser and shows me the contents of this HTML file, which is a list of every single shortcut in use in Photoshop, and also tools that don't have shortcuts associated with them. So you could print a list of these shortcuts so that you could learn those that you were most interested in learning, but you can also check to see perhaps some shortcut keys that you wouldn't ever use that you could reassign and use for a different purpose. I hope that you've enjoyed learning about keyboard shortcuts in Photoshop. Let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.